In view of the worsening insecurity in the country, in all states of the Federation of Abuja, it is feared that the country may break up or engage in a full-scale war. And only labor and other progressive forces can stop this dangerous trend that we are witnessing in our country. A retired general who once warned that no nation survived two civil wars has now called on Nigerians to rise up and defend themselves on the ground that the armed forces and the police have compromised the security of the nation. This particular general, if you must know, was the chief of army staff when in the 70s, under Obasanjo, you had Uge Priors, Oshodi Riots, Fela South, Bond, and you know, these guys were just killing. And while he was Minister of Defense under Obasanjo, you had Odi invasion in Bayelsa, Zaki Biang in Benue State, and of course, his own role in the Junkun, you know, thief war, you know, between Taraba and Benue State. The failure of the regime to control the violent attacks on farmers and destruction of farms by a group bearing AK-47 rifles, operating as elders and lopsided appointment by the Buhari regime, have fueled the separatist agenda of several groups in the country. In spite of the program of his own party, that is the APC, for restructuring or power devolution from the center to the other federated union, President Buhari has sworn arrogantly to defend the status quo. We fought the civil war. We're not going to allow anybody to break up the country. But the country is breaking on their heads. A regime that had negotiated and granted amnesty to terrorists and bandits in the recent past has rejected the call for dialogue with all separatist bodies. The latest was that the president, like his predecessor, General Lucas Obasanjo, ordered that all bandits, headers should be shot on sight. Illegally. Because there is a provision of our law dealing with illegal possession of firearms, murder and others. You will have to arrest criminal elements and put them on trial. No president has the power to order criminal suspects to be extrajudicially executed. But that was meant to give the impression that the regime has now decided to put an end to this form of criminality. It is our submission that several decades of legacy of misrule and bad governance, corruption and diversion of the Commonwealth, and anti-people's policies have led to the ascendancy of insecurity in the country. No part of Nigeria is safe today, as marauders have been abducting people, including undergraduates, secondary school students, and even primary school pupils. We have found that armed bandits, armed insurgents, armed herders, armed militias, armed coaches, armed robbers, and armed kidnappers lay siege to the country, exercising varying degrees of suzerainty over large swaths of the territory of the country. The state is incapable of ending kidnapping or rescuing abducted citizens and foreigners. In the circumstance, ransom is paid by family members and friends to secure the release of victims of abductions from captivity. Just yesterday, the governor of Niger State, an APC governor, warned the people in Abuja, the people in the villa, that these boys are coming because they are just a few kilometers away from Abuja and that they are hosting the flag of Boko Haram. Nobody has denied such, you know, statement.